Hi, my name is Shannon Crawford, and this is my Oakwood story. Oh man, before I discovered Oakwood, my experience was very, very different from what it is now. Coming from my father passing, I was living in a world that I didn't want for myself, but it was what was handed to me. Dealing with taking care of a parent, with someone who may have that experience, it's hard. Dealing with trying to keep your grades up, dealing with trying to take care of a house and not really being able to have fun or do things that other kids your age are doing because you have responsibilities now. You know, also being in the military, I have to provide and I have to work. And so now I'm living this experience that, like I said, I didn't want for myself, but now here I am. And now being at Oakwood, revitalize my spirituality, it's been a great change. I've realized that during that period in which I was in a spiritual plateau, I've realized that during those times, God was always there. You know, many times we think that God isn't there, but he's there all along, but he just may be quiet. And being at Oakwood has helped me to be able to hear his voice clearer in times of trials and times of despair. Those are the times I was able to hear him the most. And Oakwood helped me to be able to feel him, to see him, even though his presence might not have, to me, felt like he was there, but he was. Because being where I was, it wasn't productive. My spiritual life was declining. It wasn't where I needed to be. And so actually making the decision and agreeing with it in my heart actually made perfect sense. Like Oakwood is the perfect place where I can go and get caught up on my academics, bring my GPA back up and get closer to God and also be where other people are like me who are Adventists, who love the Lord, who pray in classrooms, who like to socialize together, who like to have Bible studies. So after I made the decision, it was the greatest thing that I ever did. The teachers, the caring of the teachers, they really do care for you. They are concerned about your welfare. They'll pray with you about not only your grades, but about personal information, about your family, about anything that you're going through, and they're there for you, and they'll check up on you as well, just to make sure that you're doing okay. I was at home, and I was thinking to myself, I said, Shannon, we have to change this, because my GPA was falling, just descending, and spiritually, I was on the decline. I wasn't reading my Bible anymore. I wasn't praying anymore, and I was stuck between a rock and a hard place with so many responsibilities, no one to talk to. I said, Oakwood, I believe Oakwood is the answer. And so immediately I said it in my mind that I need to go to Oakwood. Oakwood is the place that I need right now, a place where I can grow spiritually again, where I can reconnect with God again, where I can get my mind right when it comes to academics again, regaining the discipline, regaining the perseverance that's needed to be able to overcome. So, I immediately that day began to figure out my options, try to figure out what do I need in order to get into Oakwood, to move to Huntsville from Memphis, Tennessee, to enroll in classes, to clear. And so it was that day that I decided, you know what, Oakwood is the place where I need to be. And so I ended up for the fall semester of 2015, my first semester, just agonizing with God. I said, God, I don't know if I'm supposed to do electrical engineering. It feels like the safe thing to do, but I feel like I want to do theology. God, I just want peace. And I was praying to him. I said, God, I will do theology. I will switch to theology if this is what you want, but I need to know if this is what you want me to do, because I'm not going to do it on my own. It's too much of a responsibility. So I remember just praying and praying and praying and agonizing to God. And I said, Lord, please tell me. And so Oakwood Live, formerly College Days, for the Oakwood Live Chapel, Pastor Myron Edmonds came and preached a sermon that really touched my soul.
Can I help y'all with something? Most students will change their major at least 5 times in their mind. Do me a favor. Just show up here. Do what God told you to do. and then let God work with Oakwood, let God work with you as to where you're supposed to end up in life.
And I realized, instead of stepping out on faith, I was waiting for God to show me by sight. And once I realized that, it's funny, previously, I was so afraid to switch to theology. Matter of fact, I did a minor. I said, well, Lord, I'm gonna partially do it. So I keep the engineering, but I'm gonna partially do it. But after that chapel that day, I went to Cunningham, I filled out a request, and I changed my major that day with so much confidence. And I just believed that God spoke to me. And to this day, I'm about to graduate with a bachelor's in theology. Happy Mother's Day, Mom. I love you so much. There's nothing that I wouldn't do for you. I pray that you're proud of your son, and I pray that I've always made you happy. I love you.